This video focuses on derailleur hanger alignment. We'll walk through how to check and correct any issues. Hello, Calvin Jones here, Park Tool Company. Poor shifting performance can be caused by many factors, but one that's often overlooked is a misaligned derailleur hanger. The small piece of metal is the attachment point between the bike and the derailleur. If it comes out of alignment, it typically can be rebent into position. When the derailleur hanger is straight, it ensures proper derailleur to cog alignment, which is the first step towards proper shifting. A strong impact on the derailleur can cause the hanger to bend. And when the hanger is bent, the derailleur guide pulley becomes misaligned to the cogs and poor shifting is the result. Damage on the drive side of the bike is a good clue to check hanger alignment, but it's also important to check newly installed hangers as well. If the hanger is misaligned, making other adjustments, such as to the limit screw or barrel adjusters, will not be effective. Always check derailleur hanger alignment first, at least by sighting the hanger. If you're on the trail and need a temporary fix, you might just pull it until it looks straight. But in order to get a clear diagnosis and an accurate repair, you really need a derailleur alignment gauge such as the DAG-2.2. Here's a quick explanation of how to use it. In order to make the plane of the hanger parallel to the plane of the cogs, the DAG-2.2 effectively extends this plane to the rim. So we'll measure the distance to the rim as shown, then lock this measurement by tightening the knob. We then rotate the tool 180 degrees. If this gap is larger than 3 millimeters, we know our hanger needs a bit of straightening. So we bend and remeasure our distance to the rim. Now the gap is less than 3 millimeters, so we move to check the perpendicular axis. If our gaps are less than 3 millimeters, our work is complete. 3 millimeter gap at the rim means the hanger is roughly 0.5 millimeter out of alignment at the sprocket. That's where the shifting actually happens. Notice we always measure to the same place on the rim. Doing this takes wheel trueness and dishing out of the equation. A good rule is that if the hanger survives the repair process, it'll have the strength to do the job on the bike. In extreme cases, it's possible your derailleur hanger can fail during the repair process. For this reason, it's a good idea to keep a spare hanger on hand. There are many different models of derailleur hangers, and you can take time and research to source a compatible hanger with your bike, so obtain a spare before you really need it. If your bike has obstacles such as racks or fenders, simply set the O-ring on the indicator to contact the tool. Loosen the indicator knob and pull the gauge back to clear the obstacle. Return it to the reference point set by the O-ring. All right, let's walk through the process from the beginning. Mount the bike in a repair stand and level it to the ground. Check that the rear wheel is mounted straight in the frame. Remove the rear derailleur by loosening the mounting bolt at the hanger. Install the DAG-2.2 and tighten the handle, paying special attention not to cross-thread the tool. If it is difficult to thread in the tool, there may be bad threads in the hanger. Chase and clean the threads using a 10mm tap such as the TAP-10. The typical derailleur hanger is easier to bend vertically than horizontally, so corrections made horizontally can also affect the vertical alignment. For this reason, we'll correct the horizontal axis first. Rotate the arm of the DAG toward the right side of the rim at the 3 o'clock position. Rotate the wheel so the tire valve is in line with the tool. Use this point on the rim as a constant reference when checking the hanger. Move the indicator to contact the rim and secure the knob. Slide the gauge bracket toward the hub before rotating the arm. This prevents the gauge from being forced against the rim. Rotate the tool and valve stem 180 degrees to the 9 o'clock position. Slide the indicator toward the rim to the same point near the valve. If the gauge barely touches the rim or has a small gap, less than 3 millimeters, the hanger is aligned horizontally. Use a 3 millimeter hex wrench as a gauge to the gap. If the indicator is more than 3 millimeters from the rim, the hanger will need realignment. Correct this by bending the hanger using the DAG-2.2. Bend enough so that the gap is roughly half as big as before. If the hanger strikes inside the rim, the hanger may be misaligned and it may need to be corrected. However, it's easier to determine the error by seeing the gap between the rim and the gauge. So reset the tool to contact the rim at the 9 o'clock position. Now check the gap at the 3 o'clock position and measure. Bend the hanger using the DAG-2.2 so the gap is half as big as before. After bending, recheck both sides. Reset the gauge and remeasure the gap. Repeat bending and checking until the gap is less than 3 millimeters. When the horizontal positions are aligned, move on to check the vertical alignment. Keep the same setting on the indicator and bring the tool to the 6 o'clock position. If the indicator is within 3 millimeters of the rim, the process is complete and the hanger is aligned. Otherwise, set the hanger to the rim and then check at the 12 o'clock position. If the gap exceeds 3 millimeters tolerance, bend in small increments, rechecking and resetting the gauge. When the gap is less than 3 millimeters, keep the same setting and check again at the 9 o'clock position. When three points that are at 90 degrees apart are within 3 millimeters, the hanger is aligned. Remove the tool and reinstall the derailleur. And that concludes the process for derailleur hanger alignment. Now that the hanger is properly aligned, you will need to check out your derailleur's limit screw and index settings. See this video to walk through the process. And finally, be sure to check out the Park Tool Guide to Derailleurs for an overview of all of our derailleur and shifting content. Thanks for watching this repair help video from Park Tool. We're constantly adding videos and articles here on YouTube as well as our website at parktool.com. Please give this video a thumbs up if it helped you out. And of course, subscribe for the latest content from Park Tool.